kuja, lakini we tend to please ourselves. What I say here, we tend to please ourselves. How? When I say something which I may not live up to, I exaggerate about it and add more salt to it. You looking at me will rate me with what I have said. If I fail to honor it or to redeem it or to live by it, then I shall have exaggerated. And to you, you will be looking at me in those standards which first maybe the standards that you will be looking at me with will be elevated, because I elevated myself. Exaggeration brings about pride. When I say that I can do something just like somebody does it, then it means that I claim myself equal to this person. He may be my senior, may be my elder, he may be my friend, he may be my friend whom I love or I would like to be like. So when I express myself, I wear his shoes in quotes. And when I wear his shoes, I claim to be him. By that, I try to live his life. I want us to read from the book of Proverbs chapter 13. Proverbs 13. Are you there? Proverbs chapter 13 verse 12, the Bible says, hope deferred makes the heart sick, but when the desire comes, it is a tree of life. Buenas tardes. Hope deferred makes the heart sick. When somebody is hopeful, he is hopeful because you tried to exaggerate on something, or you told him something, or told her something, that she raised her heart or his heart to look at, to see it come to pass. And when it doesn't, the Bible says hope deferred makes the heart sick. When it doesn't reach, or it doesn't come to happen, doesn't come to pass, you grow weary, you grow sad, and you grow sick. Part B says, but when the desire comes, it is a tree of life. If I can exaggerate and live up to it and see it come to pass, then it brings life to the here. Bonus if you're saying. I'm just trying to make a small word out of the word exaggeration. And I'm trying to look at the kind of lifestyle which we lead as human beings. Somebody can choose to get real. You can choose to be real with yourself. But in the face of other people, you may choose to camouflage or to cover up yourself with somebody's coat, so that it is not the real you, but it is you in an exaggerated introduction with the purported you. Buenas tardes. Yes, sometimes we don't live our lives. You live your life, yes, but because of some shortcomings in life, you try to cover up with something that is not the real you. So there is a blanket that you wear. So this day I'm saying, if we live in exaggeration, we overstretch so much so that we blow ourselves out of proportion. And when you don't achieve that which you do, that you are, then I'm sorry to say you shall fail. The Bible says, in a very common verse in John chapter 16, verse 33, that in this world there are tribulations which we must pass through. Yani duniani mnayo dhiki. Lakini mkiwa na moyo mkuu mtashinda. So when you exaggerate, you get out of what you are, then you bring the false you, then the false you lets you down, then you become a stumbling block to your own self. Because when you don't live up to what you have declared, then everybody who looks at you with the very many adjectives that I will quote. You may be a cheat, you may be a liar. What else, son?
Amen.
Yeah, you may not be the person that you thought you would be. So let us not brand ourselves with the exaggerations. Let us not expect or try to bring people to this that expectation. There is a time in the book of 1 Kings when Elijah, I think it was the time of Elijah. Elijah boasted to God and he told God, you know, I'm the only prophet remaining and they are not listening to me. How many have ever come to such a point to know that Elijah boasted and God had to tell him, my friend, you are exaggerating. You don't know how many prophets there are in Israel. let me go there and read 1 Kings chapter 19. 1 Kings chapter 19. Let us read it. Verse 14. The Bible says, let me move back a little bit. Verse 13. So it was when Elijah heard it. That is when he had heard the voice of God, a still small voice. So it was when Elijah heard it that he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood in the entrance of the cave. Suddenly a voice came to him and said, what are you doing here, Elijah? Verse 14. And he said, I have been very zealous for the Lord God of hosts, because the children of Israel have forsaken your covenant, torn down your altars, and killed your prophets with the sword. I alone am left, and they seek to take my life. That is Elijah trying to please God with his words, trying to show God that he is the only one. Look at how God responds to him. God is responding. I'm telling you. I'm continuing. Verse 15. Then the Lord said to him, go, return on your way to the wilderness of Damascus. And when you arrive, anoint Hazael as king over Syria. Also, you shall anoint Jehu the son of Nimshi as king over Israel. This is God's voice. And Elisha, the son of Shaphat of Abel-Mehola, you shall anoint as prophet in your place. So God is replacing Elijah in his own way. Verse 17. It shall be that whoever escapes the sword of Hazael, Jehu will kill. And whoever escapes the sword of Jehu, Elisha will kill. Yet, I have reserved 7,000 in Israel, all whose knees have not bowed to Baal, and every mouth that has not kissed him. Bwana asifiwe sana. Verse 18 nasema kwamba 7,000. God is saying, God anaambia Elijah, it's not only you. It's not only you. It is not only you. So when we exaggerate a lot and think of ourselves, thumping our chests and thinking that we are the only ones, I'm telling you, you are just doing what God told you to do. You are just where God called you. Bwana asifiwe sana. Never exaggerate. Exaggerations are hope which are deferred, which makes the heart sick, according to Solomon in Proverbs. And me, I will say, if God has called me, I just do what God called me to do without adding anything. Peter says somewhere in 1 Peter chapter 4, I think I'll get it. Peter frames it this way. When we suffer for the glory of God, verse 12, 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12, Peter says this: Beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. It seems it is normal. Fiery trials, when they befall you, do not exaggerate. Live your life. Bwana asifiwe sana. Just live your life. You know, if there is history to be made, it is not now. If there is a fulfillment to be made, even a prophecy to be achieved, it is written. And many, very, very many prophecies have been achieved, even in this era. Bwana asifiwe sana. It can be an error, E-R-R-O-R, it can be an error in this era, E-R-A. It can be an error in this era. If we can say that we are better than others, no, we are not. We are just walking in line with where God called us. We are just in proportion to what God told us to do. So, if I say, if I think it's strange concerning the fiery trials that go about me, then I may be blowing something out of proportion. It is not true. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 12 that, Beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. There is no strange thing. There is no strange thing. You are just where the Lord wanted you to be. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Yeah. So, mi nitasema hivi ya kwamba, yes, we lead a life, we do things, we meet people, we embrace them, they go away, we say yes, Bwana asifiwe sana. We agree that this is God's will. Bwana asifiwe sana. So, here I will say that God has got a way in all things. Even before God talked to Elijah in that way, earlier on, God had still talked to Elijah in another way. 1 Kings chapter 17. Sometimes people can walk away from you, and somebody put it that it is to your progress that some people should walk away from you. But you may say that I wish people were with me forever. I wish people were with me forever. Which woman never leaves home to elope or to go away and be married? Which man never gets to an age where he leaves his father's household and walks away because of age? There is maturity and progress in walking away. Whereas we can still hold to some of our peers, or even some of us. But as we said, walking away can be progress, which is no exaggeration at all. Bonus person. 1 Kings chapter 17. There was a time when Elijah was hiding somewhere because of some decree that he had decreed. According to James chapter 5, verse 17, which I'll not read there, I'll read this version instead. Bonus person. And the Bible records that Elijah prayed, and there was no rain for 3.5 years. Then him again prayed. Then there was rain. During the time when there was no rain, there was a raven that was feeding him. And the raven fed him. Kunguru, alikuwa anamlisha. Then, God's timing was very good upon it. Bwana asifiwe sana. Watu wanaweza kuwa around you wanakulisha, wanakana wewe unasikia vizuri. Then they decide to go away. The Bible says in 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 7. And it happened after a while that the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. Just imagine. Elijah is there in the den. He is getting all that he needs, which is food, from the raven. God is feeding him through the raven. Then, all of a sudden, the brook dries up. Mali akuna pata maji. And then, something else happens. God brings a widow in his life. Verse 8. Then the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "Arise, go to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and dwell there. See, I have commanded a widow there to provide for you." Buenas tardes.
Amen.
There comes a time in life when one person comes in and another one goes away. There's a transition which God makes. When he's making it, it can be very painful. Somebody was testifying to me yesterday, somebody who is a man of God also, and he tells me that they have cell groups. So when the cell group has grown and there are so many people in it, so they go and plant a church somewhere else. So in this planting, when they are going to plant the church, they are forced to split the church so that other people get to the other place, the new place, whereas other people continue being there in this normal place. So they say that when they go there, maybe some people feel it very, very bad to part with their friends who are going to engineer the new place, to plant the church. So they say, even many walk away. They say, if so and so is not here, me, I'm going away. So they walk away. So he was telling me, like, when people stick around longer, when they stick around and they stay very much closer, they become attached and connected in such a way that they say, I wish so-and-so was here to stay. But it reaches a time when God releases this person to go. When we exaggerate that this is our church and nobody should go away and we should be here and we should stay here and we should remain here, then there will never be progress and there can never also be growth. Because in the going away of another person and getting to another place to plant another church, there is more growth in this. Because even the people in that area shall enjoy that they ought to know God through somebody or a church that is newly planted in that area. Amen?
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 So when we hold people so much, growth doesn't occur. Buona sifesa.
Amen.
Yes. I'm just preaching about exaggeration where I'm saying that when we blow things out of proportion and we say this is how it ought to be and we can never hear about anybody's opinion, we are wrong. Hope deferred makes the heart sick. Buona sifesa.
Amen.
So I'm here saying that whatever is happening around us, whatever is happening to you right now, do not think it so strange. According to 1 Peter 4:12, do not think it so strange. It is normal. And it is for the betterment of your being. I remember when the Tower of Babel was being built, God had to bring something so that people could disperse. Yes, because he didn't intend just to build a strong tower, but he intended that people might impact the earth. Bwana asifiwe sana. Ninamshukuru Mungu kwa sababu yeye ni Bwana, yeye ni mwamba wetu, na ninamfurahia. Bwana asifiwe sana. So I will say that Elijah, the brook having dried, God brought about the widow of Zarephath in transition, and there was still plenty. He never ran out. Bonus person. So let us embrace that when fiery trials come, instead of us clinging, let us leave. I want to talk about something also, which I heard some teachers talk about, a teacher talked about last Sunday. There was something that was talked about as, there was a query that was brought, isn't it? Then the query back something, then an exaggeration came. I said, I'm not going to talk about it as exaggeration, but let us talk about it as something that can build. Buona sifesa. Quiet time, it's not quiet time, it is a, nani kunyamaza, a minute of silence. See your quiet time. It is different from quiet time. It is a minute of silence when somebody dies. Buona sifesa. When somebody dies, there is a minute of silence. Then it was asked, is that not worship? Then everybody gave an analysis. Amen? Each and every person gave what they had. This is what I have to say. I did some research. I asked some other people. They told me there are some things which we can't just get out and say that I'll not be part of it, because unawares, it is being said, and you are part of the congregation, and you won't shout that you're against it. You will look irrelevant, awkward. You won't even walk away, because you must heed the authority at hand. The Bible says in Romans chapter 13, verse 2, that every authority is given of God. So there are some things which we may enter into, which don't harm us. And they won't even cast a spell upon us. No, they won't. Why? Because we are of God, born of God, in God. So some things won't reach us. Bonus person. I tried to dig deep, but I didn't dig the Google way. I just dug it other people's opinions. Bonus person. Although I happened to read something about the city of Hawaii. In Hawaii, there is something they call lei, L-E-I. Lei happens to be something which, when somebody is doing a concert, somebody comes and lays something on your neck. That sparkling thing, you know it? A wreath of greatness. There is a wreath of greatness. So in Hawaii, once you enter Hawaii at the airport, ukiland too heavy, small children are brought to you and they hang it at your neck. They hang it over your neck. And when they hang it there, this is how they welcome a visitor. But deeply underlying, there is something that is behind it that they have associated with it that appeased the gods of Hawaii. When they do that to you, they offer you to their gods. That lei, when they push it on your head, around your neck, you are bound. And one person who that was done to her, she was a woman of God. When she was brought to a certain house to sleep, she couldn't sleep all night long because there were evil spirits hovering. And as much as she tried to pray herself off, she couldn't. Why? Because the lei was hanging on her neck. And unknowingly, she succumbed because she didn't remove it. Even when she removed it, the people of Hawaii had already done something that was appeasing the gods of Hawaii. So what I may say is that even though some things may befall us, which is within or without our knowledge, there is a way out of it, just to pray about it. Yeah, just to pray about it. You pray to walk out of it. You pray about it, walk out of it. So as much as we can always repent and confess some things, repent about some things that we come across, then we can be set free, even unknowingly. Yeah, because there are some that are unbearable, that we where's the co-helper? When a president comes in our country, or another president comes to our country, and our president goes there to receive that president, maybe there are some things which are done, as we don't know what gods are appeased during that time. We don't know. We don't know whether it is just done. We don't know the origin of these things, where they started, and what makes them continue in this. Bwana asifiwe sana. Si tunaona kwa mtu akiapishwa amebeba Biblia ana hapa. How do we know whether amebeba Biblia au amebeba kitu kingine? It's not open. Neza kwa nimeandikwa Holy Bible, but there is no Bible in it. It's just a box. It may be. Imeandikwa Holy Bible, but there's no Bible in it. Then wakisha hapa, wacha waanze kuongea. Ni kama wako hapa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Yes, ni kama wako hapa. But wali hapa. Wali hapa tu na karatasi. A box. Walibeba box hivi na waka hapa. So anapoongea, anaongea tu kama hata hiyo kuapishwa ya kuapishwa. Those are our politicians. So anyway, I'm here to say that let us live our lives without exaggerating. Let us live in accordance with how God put us. Let us not blow things out of proportion so that we are irrelevant. Let us learn to embrace people, whether they are present or absent. Bwana asifiwe sana. Let us walk the walk that the Lord called us to walk. Let us be there. When in season, or even out of season. Bwana asifiwe sana. Let us rush the occasion and say, this is us. Bwana asifiwe sana. Tusimame wote. So I'll give you time. You go before the Lord. Tell God, Lord, I'm here to serve. It doesn't matter the things that are there. Lord, whatever you have put for me, this is what it has done. So I thank you for this. Punch this thing. Praise the Lord. Yeah, these fingers.
Na kwa mbudu,